Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how you can use OpenAI API with Python. So let's get started. So the prerequisites are going to be you need to have Python installed your system, and also you need to have a OpenAI or ChatGPT account with you. So now let's just begin. So just go to Visual Studio Code and open any of your folder, okay? So I'll just go and click open folder. I'll just select this folder and click on select folder. So this is the folder that I'm going to be working with, and here we will be having a new file option. Click that and let me type main.py. this is going to be our Python file, and first thing we need to have the OpenAI Python library installed, okay? So for that, just go to search and open your command prompt. I will zoom it. So it's going to be pip space install space OpenAI. So this will install us the OpenAI package. So now we are done. I'll just close this. So now we are good. Let's just begin with our code. So it's going to be import OpenAI, and next is going to be our OpenAI API key. So it's going to be OpenAI dot API underscore key. So in many cases you will be requiring to have an environment variable file, and you will be using that, but this is just a demo purpose. So I am directly hard coding my API key. So this is going to be a string. So now let's see how we can get our OpenAI API key. So for doing that, just Google OpenAI. You'll be getting the first link, and I hope you would have like logged in or signed in with your OpenAI or ChatGPT account. Just select login, and in this we need to select API, and we'll be having our profile. Just click that. We will be having view API keys. Select that. And here we will be having option to create a new secret key. Just select that and click on create secret key. And you'll be getting a puzzle. You need to complete that at first. So once we're done with the puzzle, we will be getting our OpenAI API key. And super important thing, just copy this. And you know, don't click on done without copying it. Copying it and just click on done. And don't share this key to anyone. So you need to just paste this key over here. That's it. Just come outside and come to the next line. So now we will be writing the code for our chat completion. So basically we will be sending a question, and OpenAI will be sending us a response. Exact same thing that happens in ChatGPT. So it's going to be response equal to OpenAI, this variable importing, dot chat completion dot create. Within circular bracket, we need to type the model. This is going to be the first parameter. And I'm just going to give it as GPT hyphen 3.5 hyphen turbo. So this is going to be our GPT model. And next one is going to be the messages. So this is the place where we will be sending our text prompt to the API and get the response. So we need to have this inside square bracket, and inside that we need to have a curly bracket like key and JSON thing. So it's going to be role. So the role here is going to be user, because we are the one who are sending the prompt. So we need to have it as user, and just come outside, comma, and within double quotes it's going to be content. And here we will be specifying our text prompt. So I'm just going to go with essay on global warming. Yeah, so this is going to be my text prompt, and we will be getting an essay from ChatGPT as a response. So this is now fine, and this is going to be the only prompt inside this. And just scroll down. Yeah, so this is good. And at the end we will be just printing the response. So it's going to be print response. That's it. Let me just save it, and let me just open the terminal. So for running it, it's going to be Python. Make sure that you are inside this folder, space your Python file, which is main.py in my case. So here you can see I've got some response, but I'm not getting just the text message. I'm actually getting a JSON, and inside that I'm having some keys, and inside that keys I'm having a list, and inside that I'm having my content, which is the essay. So here I'm having a global warming essay, and if I scroll down here you can see we have used 611 tokens. So for those who don't know what is a token, token is a way of measuring ChatGPT's response. That's how OpenAI does it. So if you just Google tokens to words in OpenAI, basically it says one token is equal to 3/4 words or 75% of a word, which refers to 100 tokens equals 75 words. So based upon the token only, you will be charged. So if I go to my OpenAI thing and if I go to usage, here you can see, right, based upon this token thing only, we will be charged for our credits. So then you need to make sure that you are sending out the adequate or the right amount of token. Don't send large amount of tokens because it may affect your credits and you may be getting charged more. So now let's see how we can access this message directly at first. So we are having an outer JSON, and inside that we are having choices. So this is going to be a key. So just copy that choices, response.choices. And inside the choices, we are having a list. So this is a list, and this is going to be the index 0. So it says index 0. So for that, it's going to be choices of 0. And inside that 0th index, we are having message key. And inside that message key only, we are having content, and we are having our text as its value. So choices of 0th index, we need to copy this message, and we need to put our content, which is this key that contains our text or the main response that we want to get for our text prompt from OpenAI. So this is going to be the direct response. So I'll just save it and now rerun it. So here you can see I'm getting an entire essay on global warming, but we are getting these much words, right? So as I told you, the more number of words that we get, the more tokens we consume, and the more tokens we consume, the more credits that are going to get used over here. So now let's see how we can minimize or get only a certain amount as a response. So for doing that, you can just have a condition inside our chat completion create function. So we are having messages, right? Just put a comma at the end of messages, and we'll be using a parameter called as max tokens, max underscore tokens. So this will limit the number of words that we are getting as a response. So what we saw earlier was 100 tokens are referring to 75 words, right? So I'm just going to have the max tokens as 100. So this will, okay, it's going to be equal to, yeah, so this will limit our response only to 100 tokens or 75 words. So we'll be just getting two paragraphs rather than getting the entire response. So in case if you are doing some test purposes, or in case if you want to minimize the number of tokens that are getting used, you can just add this parameter. So I will save it and I will rerun it again. And this time we will be getting much more compressed response because of this constraint that we have added. So here you can see, right, I'm just getting 3 lines, which is nearly half of the response that we got previously. And it just gets cuts off because we are just restricted the number of tokens over here. And in case if you want to learn more about this, what you can do is you can just go to that same page, the usage thing or OpenAI thing, and at the top you'll be having something called as API reference. Just click that, and to the left you'll be having the all the necessary details, introduction, authentication, and you're having for audio, chat, completions. Our main focus in this video is chat. If I click on chat, we'll be having the chat completions and everything. We will be also having the code over here for Node.js and Python, which is mostly used. So you can just copy paste the code from here also. So this is it, guys. This is how you use OpenAI's API with Python. I hope you'd have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in AI as well as programming in general. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.